Hey guys, Jordan and I are coming to you from our backyard again here, and we decided to get our homemade air cannons out and give you another look at those since we haven't had them out here for a while. And so anyway, for those of you that haven't seen it, Jordan here is holding this one. He completely designed this himself and painted it and the whole deal. The only thing I really supervised was the gluing of the PVC, just to make sure that it was completely safe. Real quick, I'll just go over. It's got a bolt-in valve stem, you know, like you'd use in a wheel. And that's good for 150 PSI. And then we have the big chamber here of PVC. And then it kind of goes around the elbow here. And then we have a big ball valve here. I believe that's a 3/4 inch ball valve, if I remember right. And then, of course, PVC barrel and everything. And then Jordan just kind of built sort of a stock for it with some rails so we can actually put a scope on it.
It had a red dot on it, but yeah, it took it off.
Lasers, that kind of stuff. The PVC, some of it's, like this is rated, the chamber's rated for 480 PSI. You know, the weakest part of the PVC is probably 240 PSI. So really the weak link in the whole thing is this valve at 150 PSI. So we never go over 100 pounds in it, just to have a little margin of safety. And if you're a kid and you're putting something together like this, you really should have your parents helping you. And because it can be real dangerous. Compressed air can really have a lot of power to it. And anyway, we're shooting a spent CO2 cartridge out of a CO2 pistol. And Jordan's got one loaded up. It's one of these little CO2 cartridges.
Put duct tape on it so it fits in there better.
Yeah, he duct taped it so it fits snug in the barrel. So, and what he's going to do, we set up a straw bale behind that board, and then we got a board and then some bottles, and he's going to see if he can shoot that bottle filled with water, and we're just going to see what it'll do because we haven't really shot one like that before. All right. You can see the steam coming out of the barrel. That's pretty cool. We'll go see what it did to the bottle. It looked like it blew it up pretty good. And as you can see, I just punched a giant hole right through the bottle. Hopefully you can see that.
I got it back that time.
And with the straw bale, at least we get it back. We used to shoot through the board and it would just go across the yard.
I'm going to try to put it, the one with your gun right in the middle.
Okay. Now, Jordan built that one, like I said, all by himself. You know, designed it and everything. Then I wanted to just kind of experiment and see how small a one I could build and still have the same kind of power. So that's when I came up with this one that we have painted in the blue tiger stripe here. Jordan actually built the stock for it here and painted it and everything like that. I just assembled the actual gun, and it's got the same ball valve, same size chamber, but just a much shorter chamber and everything. And as you can see, the handle of the gun is part of the air chamber as well. And on this one, we're just going to see if it'll shoot into the target. We're just going to shoot through the board.
Yeah.
And that's just a piece of light plywood. And we're going to see how this, goes. Here we go. All right. Ooh, it came out kind of crooked. I think you opened the valve a little.
It was slow on my part. It usually goes right through.
Yeah, I think you opened the valve a little slow. And that's kind of one of the problems with the ball valve. You got to really flick it quickly.
Well, this one right here is from it before.
Yeah. We'll load it up and do some more shots. But you can see from before where it's put some pretty substantial size holes through there.
You can actually see where you open it slow.
Yeah, it almost looks like a musket ball went through there or something, you know. But anyway, we just wanted to get out here again and give you a look at those. And we're going to pump them back up here and maybe do some more shooting and see what we can do. So thanks for watching, guys, and commenting and everything. We appreciate it. And we'll do some more vids with the air cannons in the future here. And we'll see you later. Bye.